If you've looked at Ancestry recently, then you may have noticed that your ethnicity results have changed. Does that mean that you've changed as well? Howdy, I'm Andy Lee with Family History Fanatics, and this is a segment of DNA. Be sure to hit the subscribe button and click on the bell if you want to be notified about upcoming episodes. Ancestry in 2018 made an update to their algorithm that calculates your ethnicity, and that resulted in a change of the results that are reported for lots of people. Today, I wanted to go through how my results changed and go through some of the reasons why they would have changed that way. Here we are on Ancestry's webpage. Now, to find your ethnicity results, you can just scroll down and go over to the DNA story. These are the new results that Ancestry is saying make up me. And from my own research, it's really about what it should be. Most of my ancestors are from England, with some of them from Germany. And that's exactly what I see right here, is most of my ethnicity, according to DNA, is from England and a little bit from Germany. But if I want to see how this changed from my old estimate, I can go up to the update section. And by clicking on the update section, it's going to give me a couple of bits of information. First off, it's going to tell me that this new analysis is based on 16,000 samples. And that's going to be important in just a moment when you see how many samples the old estimate was based on. In this case, more samples hopefully is going to lead to more accurate information. Next is there's 380 possible regions. Now, I only have four of those possible regions. Some people might have a dozen or more of those possible regions, depending on how mixed their heritage is. But what I want to do is I want to look at my previous estimate and see how that compares to this new estimate. Now, just off the bat, a lot of things look the same. There is that England, Wales, there's the Ireland, Scotland, there's a Scandinavia instead of Norway, and then there's that Europe West. And those are all roughly the four areas that I was in. You see that there's also three other areas here that disappeared completely from the new results. And that's, you know, should be expected, because once you get into these really small percentages, 1% or less, a lot of that may just be statistical noise. And ideally, with a larger reference population, which Ancestry has, a lot of that noise is going to disappear. And that's what I'm actually seeing in my results. Now, the next thing is the number of samples in the reference population. And here you can see that they had 3,000 samples in their old reference population. And they had 363 regions in their old reference population. So really less than 100 samples per region, if it was evenly spread, which it's not. But there is a major upgrade by going from 3,000 to 16,000 as far as the total number of reference samples. Now, I want to actually compare these results to my other results side by side. And I can do that by clicking on that. So it has zoomed into the part of Western Europe where my heritage mainly is from. And you can see that I can toggle in between what the previous estimate was and what the updated estimate is. But it's basically the same general area. Now, if we look over at the table of percentages, we can see a few little differences. First, the England-Wales area hasn't really changed the name or even what area it's covering so much, but the percentage has increased about 17%. Scandinavia has now been changed into a couple of different regions. The one that I'm apparently related to is what they call their Norway region, but it is not near as much as what the overall Scandinavian region was before, so that dropped by about 9%. The Europe West region got renamed to the Germanic Europe, and that changed by only a few percent. And finally, the Ireland-Scotland region. It decreased by about 2%, but the region itself stayed the same. So let's go back and let's look a little bit about what Ancestry says about how they're calculating these ethnicity results, because some people get confused as to whether these are accurate or whether this is just making stuff up. In the Ancestry FAQs, there are a few questions that help enlighten us on what is actually being calculated and why we might be seeing these changes. I'm just going to highlight a few of them. First off, the question, how can my DNA change because we're getting different results now? And Ancestry assures us, don't worry, your DNA doesn't change, you're still you. What has actually changed is their knowledge about analyzing that DNA and how that relates to the different ways we look at heritage. The next is, how do they actually predict the regions that your DNA is from? And Ancestry explains that they have this reference population and you're being compared to that reference population. Now, that reference population is people whose families have a long-standing documented roots in a specific area, and that's where they're getting all these different regions from. Next, why are there different regions in my ethnicity that my family members may not have? And Ancestry tells us there's two reasons for this. One is that DNA inheritance is random. And two, they've updated their ethnicity results, and so some of those regions may be showing different things. Now, another good question is, why might my ethnicity results not match what I already know about my family tree? And there's several possible reasons for this. One, you might not have inherited DNA from that region. Even though you have one or two or even a handful of ancestors from a certain region, depending on how far back they are, you may not have actually gotten that DNA from them. Another reason is that DNA may look a lot like some of the regions nearby. So maybe you have the Ireland-Scotland DNA, but you don't have the England-Wales DNA. But those two regions are right next to each other, and there's actually some overlap between them. Next is that genes don't follow the political boundaries. Genes follow the people. And people don't necessarily follow political boundaries. We cross over all the time. And their last reason they give, I like the best. Some places are complicated, and the reference that they use is Nigeria. Africa, being the birthplace of modern humans, is the most genetically diverse place on Earth. So a country like Nigeria is going to have a lot of genetic diversity, and that makes trying to figure out which parts of the DNA belong to which groups really difficult. Some people, besides just having the ethnic regions, also have certain migrations. Now, these migrations are figured out a little bit differently, but what it is it's looking at people who were known to be a part of that migration, what their DNA looks like in comparison to yours, and if yours is similar enough, you might have ancestors that were part of that migration as well. So even though Ancestry changed my ethnicity results, they didn't really change anything about me, and my results didn't really change that much. Yeah, they might have changed the names and some of the percentage of might have changed, but because all of the areas were really from that northwestern part of Europe, it didn't change. I'm still me. Now, my experience is not going to be the same as everybody else's. Depending on where you are, depending on how big that reference population was for certain areas, you may have actually seen a drastic change to your results. But in the end, it's because there's actually more information now that allows them to have a better calculation for it. Now, people are still going to ask me, well, what is the accuracy of this and whether or not Ancestry is the most accurate? Well, I still don't think that any of the companies have a large enough reference database to really say that they're the most accurate. Probably for people of European descent, they're getting to the point where some of these regions and subregions can be pretty accurate, but for most of the rest of the world, there simply is not a large enough reference population for that. If you have any other questions about your ethnicity results on Ancestry and how they may have changed, put it in the comments below and I'll try to answer it for you. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and let your friends know.